Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Good evening, good afternoon, good morning. So today in this video we'll be sharing Deloitte interview experience and interview questions. This video is contributed by one of our subscriber friend who recently have got an opportunity to have an interview with Deloitte, and he has shared his experience and we are sharing that through this video. So this is the mail that we have received, and this mail we have received on 12th September. So Deloitte interview experience. Hi Duncan, an engineer. Your channel has helped me a lot in my preparation. I started my preparation by watching your channel and later on followed other channels too. Thanks a lot for your kind efforts. I recently went through the Deloitte interview and would like to share my experience with the hope that it might help other aspirants too. It was for the role of Java J2EE consultant. I have experience of 4.2 years and package offered was 12 lakhs per annum. Below are the questions that were asked to me. Please hide my details. So here the important points are like, it was for the role Java J2EE consultant and the year's experience was 4.2 at the time of interview, and package that was offered is 12 lakhs per annum. So the topics that were covered are like the topics on which the interview has happened is Core Java, Spring Boot, Hibernate, REST, Microservices, SQL and data structures. So let's have the questions now. So these are the first four questions. My brief introduction, my project architecture and tech stack used in it. What is JVM? What are different class loaders in JVM? So brief introduction, always be prepared for this question, but don't expose yourself as if you have already prepared for that question on the brief introduction. And always prepare, like if you are saying like 3+ years of experience, then this question is a mandatory interview question. Like, what is, explain your project architecture. And if you are not able to explain your project architecture, your chances of rejection are very high, because if you are saying you are an experienced candidate and if you are unable to explain your own project architecture, so that gives a negative impact. So, and what is JVM? What are different class loaders? And for that, we can explain it in this way. So JVM, Java Virtual Machine, is an abstract machine. It is a specification that provides runtime environment in which Java bytecode can be executed. JVMs are available for many hardware and software platforms. That is, JVM is platform dependent. JVM performs following operations. It load codes, it verifies the code, it executes the code, it provides runtime environment. And coming to the class loaders, class loader is a subsystem of JVM which is used to load class files. Whenever we run a Java program, it is loaded first by the class loader. Then there are three built-in class loaders. Those are bootstrap class loader, extension class loader and system application class loader. So what bootstrap class loader does is, this is the first class loader which is superclass of extension class loader. It loads the rt.jar file which contains all the class files of Java standard edition, like java.lang package classes, java.net package classes, etc. You can see java.util, java.io, java.sql package classes, etc. And coming to extension class loader, this is the child class loader of bootstrap and parent class loader of system class loader. It loads the jar files located inside Java home jarlib extension directory. And coming to the system or application class loader, this is the child class loader of extension class loader. It loads the classifies from class path, but by default class path is set to current directory. You can change the class path using the following commands. So these were the first four questions. And before getting into questions, I would like to discuss something here. Do you know a lot of companies now hire based on your talent and skills, but not based on your education qualification or from which college you are? And if you think you have got all the relevant skills for a job in front-end development, the guaranteed salary of minimum 4 lakhs per annum for non-tech roles and 6 lakhs per annum for tech roles, and this can go up to 15 lakhs or more. There is no age restriction to apply. Experienced candidate can get up to 50% hike on their current salary package by applying to their next job through Relevel. I am going to share you two amazing companies which will hire you just in 15 days. And those two companies are Rapid Technologies and Animal. So So coming to rapid technologies, you can see the team sizes of 11 to 50. CTC can go up to 10 lakhs per annum, and the headquarters is there in Bangalore. And coming to animal, the team sizes of 50, salary can go up to 20 lakhs per annum, and it is also the headquartered in Bangalore. Now, who hasn't heard about these two companies? These companies are now hiring freshers and people with no experience to Relevel by an academy. All you need to do is register for the Relevel test, which is totally free. No more video resume is required. After this, you can give the test as per your comfort and get amazing job based on your skills. And you can check the Relevel by Relevel Achiever Twitter page as well here to see how many people are getting hired daily. Like, this is just uploaded 2 hours back. Anubhav, whose score was 748 out of 1000, is a sales executive at Practically, and there are many more. You can go through that. The best thing about Relevel is no degree or specific qualification is needed. Relevel test is free and open to all age groups. Relevel achievers who have switched jobs have secured up to 50% salary hike from the previous job. Minimum salary or 4 lakhs for non-tech roles and 6 lakhs for tech roles. Maximum salaries can go up to anything in the double digit. And video resume is also not required. And all this can happen if you take the Relevel test, which is of free of cost. And continuing with the question, why string class is immutable? Because string uses string constant pool, which is shared across different objects. So that is the reason string class is made immutable. How to make a class immutable? Yeah, we had answer on this as well. What are basic OOPs concepts? You can go with polymorphism, encapsulation, abstraction. What do you understand by abstraction? How can it be achieved? So basically, abstraction is hiding of things, and this can be achieved through interfaces and abstract classes. And here we can answer like how to create immutable class in Java. We can create our own immutable class in Java. Prior to going ahead, go through the characteristics of immutability. The class must be declared as final, so its child classes can't be created. Data members in the class must be declared private so that the direct access is not allowed. Data members in the class must be declared as final so that we cannot change the value of it once the object is created. Parameterized constructors should initialize all the fields and by performing a deep copy so that the data members can't be modified with the object reference. Deep copy of object should be performed with the getter method to return a copy rather than returning the actual object. So this is how we can answer this. So the next section of questions, what are functional interfaces? So we have to explain what are functional interfaces. So basically, this is introduced in Java 8. So it has only one method. So how can you override the default methods from a functional interface? I don't think we can override that thing. If you know the answer, you can provide that in the comment section. Which collections have you used in your project? So it depends from person to person and project to project. What is the internal working of HashMap? So I have to explain in detail about the internal implementations, like how the bucket is calculated, how the getter method works, how the setter method works. Sorry, add method. So why was concurrent HashMap introduced? How it is different from HashMap? So basically, concurrent HashMap, whenever it is used in multi-threaded environment, instead of locking the entire map object, it just locks the segment. So other multiple threads can act upon the concurrent HashMap. So this cannot be happen with the HashMap. On the HashMap, the entire object gets locked. So that issue it resolves. Coming to the next question, why do you use ArrayList? Does it allow duplicates? Yes, it allows duplicates. And why do you use it? Depends on the requirement. It depends upon the scenario, like way to use ArrayList or to use any other list class. What are the new features of Java 8? So you can list down all the new features of Java 8. What is multi-threading? How have you implemented it in your project? So it again depends upon the project. Like multi-threading and running different processes. What is JUnit? How have you written JUnit test cases for your repository class? So basically, JUnit is nothing but testing our code. And coming to writing the repository, we usually mock the repository calls. How does the Spring Boot application work? Explain the flow. So I have to explain about all the what happens when we run a Spring Boot application as Java, run as Java, when we do a run as Java command, when we initiate that, what will happen. So how it gets bootstrapped, what all things happen first, and all those things should be explained here. How do you accept requests from the client? Which annotations have you used? So basically here indirectly he's asking us to create a REST API, we can say, which accepts something, and what all annotations we use, whether we are using a thread controller or a thread REST controller, and all those things. Which design pattern have you used in your project? So again, this depends upon, like, vary from project to project. I have to explain that this is specific to the individual. How do you call a web service from your microservice? So we can use Fiend client or we can use REST template as well. Mostly Fiend client we will be using, which is advanced one. Explain the annotation at the Spring Boot application. So it is basically a combination of three annotations, and you can list down all those things. What is the difference between a thread component and a thread bin? So a thread component can directly be at the class level, and a thread bin is at the method level, and we need a thread configuration so that a thread bin works. What are the various scopes of bin? So in Spring we have singleton, prototype, request, session, and global. So we have to explain in detail about which scope you will go with in which scenario. So difference between singleton and prototype. So singleton is one for the container, and prototype is whenever we request that, we'll be getting that bin. What is session in Hibernate? Is it thread safe? Difference between session and session factory. How do you call a stored procedure using Hibernate? So these were the three questions that are from the Hibernate. So how have you handled security in your microservices? This is one of the important questions. So what all things you have considered, what all things you do to provide security to your applications. Usually we do it with tokens, JWT tokens. So like in my project, we do using tokens. So I'm saying that you can have your own way of doing it. Explain the deployment process in your project. So we use Jenkins pipelines to deploy. So mostly now everyone is moving to cloud. So this will be the answer, CI/CD pipelines. What is Docker? What are its advantages? What is Jenkins? So I have to explain this. What benefit we are getting out of Docker or Docker images? What is Jenkins process? What is does? So do you write any scripts? These kind of questions you can expect on Jenkins. Given a list of numbers, find the second largest number from it in Java as well as an SQL query. So this was the only coding question that was shared with us. So by using the Java code as well as the SQL query, we need to write the SQL, we need to provide the solution to the given question. So these were the 33 questions that were shared to us, guys. So I hope you liked the video and it might help someone, and this would be provided in the description as well. So, and if you are on our channel for the first time, and if you are wondering who are we and what we do, so we are basically a bunch of software engineers who attend interviews with different MNCs and share our real-time interview experiences through this video and the company names which you are seeing on your screen. So these company interview experiences we have already shared. You can visit our channel and get benefited out of it. And if you haven't subscribed us, please do subscribe. And if you want to share your interview experience, you can mail us at the email ID that is there in the description, and it might be helpful to others as well. So if you haven't subscribed us, please do subscribe, like, share, provide your feedback whether these videos are helpful to you or not, and thank you for watching. And before that, one thing is, we have an Amazon association link in the description. You can use that link on your next purchase on Amazon. Bye for the next video.